right, very inspiring words. Nigeria will be a great nation again if we use what we make and make what we use. And that's the message from key speakers at the 9th edition of the Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu Colloquium held in Lagos.
Olawakon has details.
Based to our common national issues. Consequently, the Bola Tinubu Colloquium.
Greatness is best measured by the degree of impact on humanity. Asiwaju Bola Tinubu has no doubt positively affected many lives. The caliber of dignitaries at the 9th edition of Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu Colloquium in Lagos to commemorate his 65th birthday is a reflection of his invaluable greatness. Dignitaries and party faithful talked about the celebrator and how he has contributed to the development of Nigeria.
Asiwaju is a made in Nigerian product. We should make more products out of him. This year's central theme is no doubt an apt topic. Make it in Nigeria, use what we make, make what we use.
Bola Ahmed Tinubu epitomizes excellence in all its ramifications. Excellence in public service, excellence in private life, excellence in governance.
It's a great moment for that cementing that achievement. It shows, you know, the path he's taken has been very fruitful and very rewarding for Nigeria and for Lagos in particular.
Are you made in Nigeria? You're not sure.
I do not want to answer the question, please.
Well, I am. I'm made in Nigeria. Well, joining us now is an economist, Gabriel Idahosa. And, of course, we'll be joined also from Port Harcourt by a public affairs analyst, Andrew Ajayi. Good morning, gentlemen. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning.
I wonder what you make of this statement coming from Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu that we should use what we make what we use, and make what the world values. Of this three in one statement, which one really, you know, pops out to you?
We need to make what we use.
Okay.
That's the absolute minimum for any respectable nation. Mm. If you can't produce the basic things you know, you really need, then you don't have a place in the committee of great nations. You'll be permanently dependent on other countries of the world. Mm-hmm. So it's critical that you're able to
make
produce
what you use.
The key things that you use. Food, for example. Mm-hmm. You can't rely on other countries to feed you and say you are a serious nation.
All right, let's go to Port Harcourt now and bring Andrew Ajayi. Our guest in the studio said the key thing is to produce what we use. How about using what we produce? Uh-huh. Is that also important?
Okay, unfortunately, we can't hear Andrew Ajayi. We'll try to fix that audio as quickly as we can. Now, we built the nation we seek by forcing ourselves to become that nation, also ascribed to BAT, Bola Tinubu. Now, the thing is, how did we even move from, you know, when you hear about the history of Nigeria and how we used to have the granite pyramids, you know, palm oil was in abundance because we produced and used and ate and consumed. We moved from that to a nation that actually almost totally depends on the outside world for everything.
Yes, the thing is, the future to a large extent is created by us, whether as individuals or as a nation. If we want to be a great country, it's essentially created by us. When we had oil, we decided we didn't need to work anymore. Mm-hmm. We could eat all the rice from wherever. We could import everything. Money was no longer a problem. And that's how we got to where we are. Mm. But before oil, we had nothing else to make us lazy.
Okay, let's go to Port Harcourt now. We hope the audio is fine now. Andrew Ajayi, many thanks for joining us. So the question was, if it's good to produce what we use, but do we use what we produce here in Nigeria?
Well, those are two different things. And I'd like you to know that statement of the people feeling proud, okay, and also internalizing themselves to want to also be great the way other people are great in the world is actually what brings about a positive foundation for a people. So it is two things we are saying. Produce what you want to use. That is one aspect of it. Then the other aspect, of course, is the way you have asked the question. You must produce what you want to consume. And you must also consume what you produce. Any people that are not doing this as a people living in a nation, for God's sake, they will continue to be what I call follow. They will follow other people of the world by consuming their products the way we are currently consuming Nigeria, Chinese product, American product, Dubai product, and what have you. So any group of people, irrespective of their tribe and religion, that lives in a geographical entity and does not take pride in what they produce to be able to consume it. I want to even go very local and colloquial. Mm-hmm. If you are a Nigerian, your product is amala, fufu, eba, olugo soup, and you don't want to eat it. You say you want to eat spaghetti and what have you. For God's sake, you are doing yourself a great disservice. So for me, I want to see a Nigeria that leadership will galvanize the mind and body and soul of our citizens to now be appreciating what is bad. Even what I'm wearing here now, as I talk to you, is a Nigerian-made thing. If it were to be made in America or China or even Japan, and they bring it to me as Andrew Ajayi, I will not wear it.
But there's a danger of that actually happening. There's a danger of that happening. We hear that India is now bringing us Gari and what have you. But I can be sure that the fabric you're putting on may actually be imported. It was only sewn in Nigeria. Isn't that the real fundamental issue that we need to attack? But you know what, Dan? Sorry, not Dan. Andrew. Andrew, just hold on. Of course, yes. Guest in the studio, Mr. Idehosa. Just hold on, gentlemen. We'll take a short break and then we'll come back to this. Stay with us.
Glad to have you back. You're watching TVC Breakfast, and we are on to our third big story this morning. We're looking at making it in Nigeria. How do you make it in Nigeria? If it is made in Nigeria, do you consume what is made in Nigeria? And we have with us in the studio our guest here, an economist, Gabriel Idehosa, and from Port Harcourt is a public affairs analyst, Andrew Ajayi. Just before we went on that short break, Ngozi took you on what you're wearing, that it could be sewn in Nigeria, but was it really made in Nigeria?
Thank you very much. I just have to be honest with you. I'm not into importing and exporting, so I would not really know whether the fabric is actually made here. But the truth of the matter is that I even have something to say there. I will conclude when I want to round off now that whatever we are doing as a people, we must have this consciousness of the fact that we are a great people. Because look at what is happening all over the world. Nigeria virtually became a dumping ground. And that is because we are the ones who causes it. Our appetite for foreign-made produce has eaten deep into our fabric that it makes us look as if we don't even know who we are. So I therefore want to use this opportunity to call on all men and women who are into the importing and exporting, you know, activities in Nigeria to say that why we are not saying that you should not engage in international trade where you should bring in products to your own country. To be able to help the Nigerian economy and to help the Nigerian as a people and even their youth as they are growing up. Can you begin to tell these manufacturers, technologies to say that whatever product we want to get from you to come into Nigeria for Nigerian people to consume, can you begin to have the factory? Can you begin to have the manufacturing and industrialized companies here so that whatever you are producing, even be it Nokia phone or any other telephone or any other product, be it cars and what have you, at least as you have the factories here, instead of looking for foreign exchange to go and be importing all those things, you will no longer need foreign exchange if these companies are situated in Nigeria here. Mm-hmm. By so doing, that product that is going to be produced, or that you hitherto should have imported from America, but because it is going to be produced in Nigeria here now, that product is still going to be a made in Nigeria product. So it depends on the way government is thinking, because we actually have no means of production other than to produce garri, amala, fufu, ewedu. That is what we produce here. I want to see a Nigeria that will be producing in this type of mentality that I have just explained.
Right. In other words, Gabriel Idahosa, why not chocolate instead of just cocoa or the raw material and all of that? Now, the Vice President, Yemi Osinbajo, when he visited Aba, actually promised that the federal government would remove bottlenecks in the way of, you know, that's actually militating against SMEs. And those are the ones that will actually turn this economy around if we're really serious. Is the political will really there? And what would you even say are some of the impediments or bottlenecks in the way of the manufacturer, the SMEs, the MSMEs, and all of that?
The primary thing, if you want to produce anything, mm-hmm. you need power. And as simple as the packaging, for anything, just the packaging, not the product itself. Mm. You need power. And if you have to have a generator for any kind of activity, and your competitor in China or Singapore or South Africa has 24 hours uninterrupted power of the right quality to run your factory, you are in a different league. Mm. You are not in the same league as those manufacturers.
Which brings us to the third leg of Ashwaju's statement, what the world values. Because if what you've produced is not really good, then it's of no use. Okay, but he also provides some solutions. Apart from, you've mentioned infrastructure now, and he also provides some solutions to getting us there. One of them, of course, is industrial policy on barring of some exports goods into the country, especially textiles. That policy should come back in place. Do not import textiles into the country and some other things that we could produce here in Nigeria.
So that when we say made in Nigeria, we actually mean made in Nigeria.
It just so happens that the policy is more important than everything else.
Yes. Mm.
If you look at telecom today, why are we here? Policy. Simple policy of saying no more a monopoly of the old Nitel.
Yeah.
Anybody who has money to come to Nigeria, get a license and enter the telecom industry. And you see what we made of it. The same thing with power. The trouble with power now is that we have privatized the GEMCOs, the generating companies, we have privatized the distributing companies, but the core that brings the two together, the transmission, we have not privatized. So it is still bogged down by everything that has to do with a government-run organization.
So would you be on the same page then, you know, as Andrew, when he says, look, there's a need for a strong government policy as far as, take BMW, for example. You have BMW in South Africa. They're building, actually assembling from the scratch in South Africa. And so many other companies. Nigeria cannot even produce needles for injections. So if we cannot get it right, at that level, where are we going from here?
It's not that there is a need. There is no option to good policies. Mm-hmm. That is why every year the World Bank does this ease of business study.
Yes.
And it's the gold standard for finding
I think we're still ranked 169 out of 190.
Is the gold standard for finding which countries are doing well. Mm. Whether it is Rwanda, whether it is Mauritius, whether it's a large country like China, just look at their ease of business. Once you fix policies and ramp up your ranking, everything, the foreign exchange, people move money to where there are good policies. People will go, even tourism, people will visit countries that have good policies and produce the right infrastructure. So policy is the absolute minimum for transforming any economy.
Okay, so Andrew, now talking about make it in Nigeria, is this really achievable if Aba is not seriously focused on generally, the Southeast, some people will tell you that in Newe, for example, you find unbelievable ingenuity on the part of those people there. You actually have some who built cars. I mean, you have Innocent anyway. And then I remember a group of UNILAG, University of Lagos students, who actually put a vehicle together, and they're saying in another 10 years, they can actually achieve the electric car. Now, that's coming from young people. But it seems nobody is looking in their direction to look at maybe funding or encouraging them in some way or the other. Andrew.
Thank you very much, my lovely sisters. You see, I must be very, very honest with you because I am passionate about the development of Nigeria. That is even why when I was told that this is the topic for today, I said, wow, okay, I will leave other things to be here. You see, in terms of our government, that those who are opportune today, even tomorrow and in the future, to be policy makers, what is the vision, what is the mission and the dream in their head as it has to do with the development of this country? Since 1960 till today, I do not think leadership that we have had is such that wants to see Nigeria becoming a manufacturing, industrialized, and consumers of made in Nigeria products orientation. That is not the orientation. Because if that is the orientation, since 1960 till today, we would have been having what I call a near getting there of, you know, produce in Nigeria, consume in Nigeria.
Okay.
Today, when we talk about the industrialization that is in Abia State, Aba, to be precise, do they have electricity to power these activities that they do? If you go there, the fumes that comes out of the generator that they use is enough to use carbon monoxide to kill you right there.
Okay, so, all right, Andrew, you're staying on the same point of infrastructure. Well, you're staying on the same point of infrastructure. We are wrapping up this segment now, but Gabriel, quickly, just in the area of credit and tax holiday or tax credit to companies, how can the government come in, apart from the expansion grant that has been reintroduced now as we speak? Apart from that, how else can the government help?
We need to reduce taxes. We need to simplify tax payments. And we need to relate taxes to actual incomes. Quite often, government now imposes taxes based on assumed income. They assume that you have made X profit and they tax you. It's all back to policy, really. In every branch of activity, and it is not rocket science. The countries that have succeeded have reformed their tax systems. So you have templates you can take, whether it's from Singapore or Mauritius, and you really don't need to walk too
like high. They say, we're not reinventing the wheel.
No.
All right, gentlemen, we have to say thank you so much at this point. Gabriel Idahosa is an economist, and Andrew Ajayi, a public affairs analyst, for joining us this morning. Thanks for your time and
looking
your insights.
We're done.
Never enough time. All right, thank you so much. There's so much more to discuss on TVC Breakfast. Stay with us.